ala rasulihi al-kareem amma ba'd fa'uz billahi min ash-shaytan jim bismillah ar-rahman ar-rahim. Book of fasting we are doing, inshallah. We'll do first chapter, fardiyatu siyam. Fasting is obligatory. Fasting is the one of the fundamental obligatories of Islam. Ibn Umar radiyallahu ma transmits that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam states, the foundation of Islam is based on five pillars. First, the Shahada, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. And second is to, you know, then establish Salah. And third, to pay Zakah. And fourth, to do Hajj. The fifth one is the month of fasting, that is Ramadan. This is in Bukhari. So, an Ibn Umar radiyallahu anhuma qala qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bunyanin Islam ala khamsin, five, shahadati anna la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadur Rasulullah wa iqamus salata wa itai zakata wal hajji wa sawmi Ramadan, rawahu Bukhari. So these are the five obligatory, these are the five pillars of Islam. Let's see next hadith. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu transmits that a Bedouin visited the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and requested him to instruct in deeds that when acted upon would enter him into the paradise. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, worship Allah and join none with him in worship, perform the obligatory prayers, pay the obligatory charity, that is zakat, and observe fast in the month of Ramadan. And listening to it, he told that he would not add to anything by himself. Who Bedouin is saying? When he returned back, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam pointed that person, like Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam pointing that person, one who likes to see the man of paradise, he should see him. This is also in Bukhari. So here the words of the hadith, an Abi Huraira radiyallahu anhu, an Arabiya ati Nabiyya sallallahu alaihi wasallam faqala dulanni ala amali iza amiltahu daqalat al jannah. Who will enter the Jannah? Qala ta'budullaha la tushriku bihi shay'a, not doing shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa tuqimu salat, like, you know, doing salah, establishing salat. And then wa atu zakah, and giving the zakat, and that is mafruda wa tausum wa Ramadan, and doing the saum in the Ramadan. Wa qala wallazina nafsi biyadihi la azidu ala haza, he said, I am not going to do more than this. Means he will completely accept and do it. Here, have you noticed, like, in this Hajj is not mentioned. Maybe it was not fardiya on this person, depending on his, or maybe it has not been mentioned here. So depends what was the scenario. But previously we have seen about the Khamsa, we have seen Munyanul Islam and Khamsa, in that Hajj was also mentioned. So it doesn't mean he is exempted. Okay, let's see the Fadlus Sawm, excellence of fasting. So what are the excellence of fasting? With the commencement of the month of Ramadan, the gates of paradise are open and gates of hell are closed. So here, the gates of Jannah are open as soon as Ramadan comes. How Ramadan comes? When we moon sight it with the lunar calendar. And the gates of hell are closed. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrates that the Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, when Ramadan comes, the gates of paradise are open and the gates of hell are closed, and the evil ones are imprisoned. And this is in Bukhari and Muslim. So here, an Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu qala qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam iza daqala Ramadanu, means as soon as Ramadan daqala entered, futihati awwabu, the gates are open of as-samai, and as-samai here wa ghullifat abwabu jahannam, the gates of the paradise are open here, and ghullifat, and the doors of jahannam is hellfire, that is close, and sulsilati shayateen, and also shayateen are chained. So this is the hadith mentioned in Bukhari and Muslim. And next, see the next hadith. The reward for the performance of Umrah in the month of Ramadan is equivalent to the performance of Hajj. Anas radiallahu anhu relates that he heard from Abbas radiallahu anhu that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked a woman of Ansar. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu had related the name of the woman, but he had forgotten. Okay, he forgotten it. Why do you not accompany us to perform the Hajj? The woman replied, we have only two camels, my husband and son gone to Hajj. Okay, with one camel, her husband and son went to Hajj. On the other, we use it for the household chores. We transport water, etc. on it. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, when Ramadan comes, perform Umrah. Its reward is equal to the Hajj, and this is in Muslim. So it doesn't mean that, you know, they are exempt from the doing Hajj, but you know, when you perform Umrah at the time of Ramadan, it is equivalent in reward to Hajj. But some people, they misunderstand and they say, if we do Umrah, we have to do Hajj compulsory. Make a niyyah, make an intention, at least go in Ramadan time for the Umrah, and inshallah Allah will make your way for the Hajj too. But it doesn't mean that you are exempted. You have to do the Hajj too. So here we have seen in the hadith that it's mentioned clearly, she has to, like, you know, if she does this, that is the equivalent of Hajj. On the day of judgment, fast will intercede for the person who observe it. Subhanallah, the fasting, what we are doing in Ramadan time, this fasting, we are talking about Ramadan fasting, okay? So here Abdullah bin Amr radiallahu anhuma narrates that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, fast and Quran will intercede for the servant on the day of judgment. What? Fast and Quran. These two things will intercede on the day of judgment. Fast will state, O my Lord, I have prevented this servant from eating and drinking and from satisfying his desire. Hence, accept my intercession for him. You have to understand, you know, when we fast, even though everything is halal, but we stop ourselves. We don't eat anything and we don't say anything which is not appropriate. And also we stop ourselves from husband-wife relationship, which is halal otherwise. But in the time of fasting, we stop ourselves. And Quran will state, O my Lord, I have prevented this servant from sleeping in the night for worship. You know, when we want to sleep, sleep is sometimes, you know, some people, they can't stop sleeping. That is their problem. They can't overcome. But Quran will say, intercede and will say, no, I, you know, they recited Quran in the night too. Hence, accept my intercession for him. Accordingly, intercession of both will be accepted, transmitted by Ahmad and Tabrani. So here when we see the wordings, and Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, As-siyamu wal-Qur'an yashfani li-abdi yawm al-qiyamah. These two things, siyam and Qur'an, will yashfani, do the sifaj, do the intercede yawm al-qiyamah. Yaqulu siyamu ay rabbi mana'atuhu ta'ama wa-shahwa. You know, siyam will say, fasting will say, he stopped himself from ta'am, you know, eating. And wa shahwa, you know, all I mentioned about shahwa, like, you know, all the pleasures, like whatever we want to do, especially we are talking about here, sexual desire. And it will, for shifa, it will shifa fihi for them. Wa yakulul Qur'an, and Qur'an will say, mana'atuhu naum, I stopped them from sleeping, bilayli wa shafani fi, and I will intercede because they stop sleep and they recited Quran. In this, you know, when we do tahajjud time, not only doing reciting the Quran, also reciting in your salah nawafil, and these two will be intercede by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's see the next hadith, inshallah. The reward for fasting is immeasurable, like, you know, you can't measure it. It's going to be that much. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrates that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, the reward for every good deed of a person is increased by 10 to 700 times according to the intention and sincerity. But in respect of reward for fasting, Allah proclaims, fasting is for me, and I myself shall bestow and reward. The person who fasts forgoes his desires, eating and drinking. For my sake, he will be entitled to two kinds of delight. You know, now two kinds of delight. What are they? One at the time of breaking the fast. Isn't it? When we break the fast, how we feel happy. And the other at the time of meeting his Lord, inshallah. Allah's Messenger further, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, further stated, the odor of the mouth of a person who fasts is more pleasing to Allah. You know, when you fast, you feel that because you're not eating, you have that odor. But what Allah says, that odor is so pleasing to Allah than the aroma of musk. He further states, fast act as a shield against sinful acts. Fasting is act as a shield against sinful acts. Therefore, when any person is fasting, he should avoid obscene and absurd language, you know, bad language, foul language, inappropriate things, and also language and gestures. If anyone abuses him or quarrels, you know, sometimes some people, they come and quarrel, you are in fasting with him, he should say, I am fasting. This is in Bukhari and Muslim. So we have seen few things. Just let me remind you first what we learned here in this hadith. It's a longer hadith narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. So here it's meant that kullu amali ibn adam lahu illa siyam, all the things what we are doing is for himself. Like Ibn Adam means all of the people. Illa Siyam. Except Siyam is for who? Fa innahu ila. This is for our Rabb. This is for our Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wana ajri bihi wa siyamu jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, for Siyam, for fasting, I will give Jannah. And fa iza kana yawma sawmi ahadikum fala yarfautu yawma izin wala yakhtasab fa inna. And you know, when somebody, when they are fasting, how they should stop themselves from the things which is forbidden for us. Inni imraun siyamu wallazi nafsum. And you know, when you are fasting, you should tell, I am fasting. And then here also said, you know, when who is fasting, min rihi misk. You know, the mouth odor is like a misk, riya misk, lisiyami, farhatani. And those two happiness are there. Farhatani is dual. You know, those who understand Arabic, it's when farha, farhatani, yafrahuma, and they will happy. What is a aftara fariha? First is when we do iftar, that is fariha. Bifatrihi wa iza lakhya rabbahu, when we meet our Rabb, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Farihas bis saum. And this is Rawahu Muslim. So inshallah we'll continue in the next part. This is the part 1 Ramadan topic. Jazakallah khair. Subhanakallah ma bihamdika. Nashadu la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka.